So the fault tolerance techniques that are used often are checkpointing, where we can save the state of the system periodically, then we detect errors and restore the state of the system once we detect an error. This type of technique works really well for many transient and also intermittent faults. So the idea here is that we will save the state of the system when the system is functioning normally. If a fault occurs, we will try to detect errors that result from that and restore the system into a state that was not affected by the fault. So if the fault is transient, it will not happen again and our system goes back to functioning normally. If the fault is intermittent, then this might happen a few times until we reach the time when the fault is no longer going to be activated, and then again we will function normally. So the system continues to function normally if we can quickly recover from each of the faults so that it doesn't affect the overall availability and reliability of the system. If checkpointing takes too long, then this type of recovery has to be treated as service interruption. But if checkpointing and detection and restoring of the state are very, very fast, it may be that the promised service is never disrupted. So for example, if the system is supposed to answer all the web queries within, let's say, 1 second, if we manage to do all of this in such a way that we still respond to all of the things that we got in 1 second, then there has been no service interruption. We can use two-way redundancy, where two modules do the same work, then we compare their results, and we roll back if the results are different. So this is really an error detection technique, and it needs a recovery technique such as checkpointing. Similarly, checkpointing is a recovery technique. It needs something like two-way redundancy to actually detect errors. And while these techniques recover and detect things separately, we can also have something like three-way redundancy, which can both detect and recover some faults. And in this case, three modules or more will do the same work and then vote for what the correct result should be. So if one module is malfunctioning, then the two others will still produce the same result, and that result will be elected by the vote as the overall correct result. So the fault in one module becomes an error in that module, but doesn't become an error at the system level, because at the output of these three modules and their voter, we always have an error-free result. This technique is expensive. You pretty much need 3 times the hardware plus the voter that you would have without some fault tolerance techniques. But in return, it can tolerate any fault that can occur in any one of the modules. So as long as the fault that you have is affecting only one module, we can tolerate that fault. Even, for example, if that one module is purposely designed to be malicious, because the correct two are still going to outvote it and we never really see whatever that module is trying to produce in our overall results. But what happens if two modules fail? In that case, we no longer can tolerate that.